Hey there, welcome to another Affinity Photo tutorial. In this video, we are going to create this really cool Scanlines effect. So let's get started. First, we will start by creating a new square canvas that is 1080 pixels on each side. This gives us a nice clean frame to work with. Next, place the portrait image onto the canvas. Scale it to fit within the canvas. Now, create a duplicate of the image layer and hide the original. Rename this layer to copy and then apply a live motion blur filter. Now increase the blur radius to around 350 pixels and make sure to check the preserve alpha box to remove the white edges. To make sure the face stays sharp and in focus, add an empty mask to the motion blur layer. Then using a black brush with 50% opacity, 25% flow and 0% hardness, carefully paint over the face area to selectively unblur that part of the image. Next, add a live noise filter on top of the motion blur layer. Set the noise intensity to 50%. Change the type to uniform and check the monochromatic box. Drop the overall opacity of this layer to around 80%. Then holding the Alt key, drag the mask from motion blur filter and drop it onto this noise filter to remove the noise from the face. Now for the halftone effect, add a live halftone filter on top. Change the screen type to line, set the cell size to 5 and increase the contrast to 50%. Then lower the opacity of this layer to 75%. To really make the scan lines pop, apply a threshold adjustment layer. Increase the threshold up to around 65%. And drop the overall opacity to 60%. Then use the levels adjustment to increase the black level to 10% and decrease the white level to 90%. Finally, to give the image a nice look, nice color paint, add a recolor adjustment layer. Increase the saturation by 30%. And drop the lightness by 10%. You can experiment with the hue slider to find a color you like. And there you have it. That's the step-by-step process for creating this cool scan lines effect in Affinity Photo. Remember, the specific values I used may not work perfectly for every image. So feel free to experiment and tweak the settings to get the look you are going for. Have fun and happy editing.